try to compute a following integral yourself first, and then you can see in this video whether your computation is correct and whether you have included all steps. So we have the following integral, contour modulus of z equals 1, e to the power iz divided by z minus 2 cubed, where the contour is traversed once in positive direction. So for solution, we can try to use Cauchy's integral formula. And the derivative of a function at z0 equals the f of z divided by z minus z0 to the power n plus 1. And then here we have an n factorial divided by 2 pi I. How can we apply it? Well, we define f of z equals e to the power I z, z0 to be 2 and to be 2 as well. Then we can compute f double equals, so differentiate f twice. You get I times e to the power I z, so minus e to the power I z in 2 yields minus e to the power 2i. And then we can apply the integral formula to compute our integral. Bring the n factorial over 2 pi I to the other side. So you get 2 pi I divided by 2 factorial second derivatives, which gives you a minus pi I times e to the power 2i. Now, are all the steps correct, or is one of the steps or more steps wrong? Well, let's see. Cauchy's integral formula, correct. Conditions are missing, so that could lead to some problems, but okay. This choice over here, you can always make this choice. That's correct as well. However, this step is wrong, and our answer is wrong. And why is it wrong? Well, the problem is actually, I think, already in the first step, where the conditions of Cauchy's integral formula are not given. Like, the conditions are that f of z should be analytic on an inside C. That's okay. C is simple and closed. Okay, that's fine as well. But also z0 should be inside C. And that's not the case. So you cannot apply Cauchy's integral formula like that over here, because your z0 is not inside C. So, second solution. We make the picture of our contour and of our singularity at z equals 2. And then we see, well, the singularity of f of z is at z equals 2 is outside C, so we use Cauchy-Gossa, and we conclude that our integral equals 0. Is this correct now? Almost, but not entirely. Singularity is indeed outside of C, but what you need is that f of z is analytic on and inside C. Well, that's the case here. Fz of z is a quotient of analytic functions, and then the denominator is nowhere zero in C or on C. So your f of z is indeed analytic, so then you can use Cauchy-Gossa. So those are the key ingredients for the correct solution. So what is what's wrong over here? Well, you only say that your singularity is outside of your domain, but what you need is that your function is analytic everywhere inside your domain and on C. But why? Well, isn't that the same? Well, we will see another example where exactly this can be the problem. So, if you want to use Cauchy-Gossa, really check its conditions to see whether you can indeed apply it.